A U.S. Air Force B-2 Spirit stealth bomber recently deployed a new anti-ship weapon to sink a decommissioned warship in the Pacific and a cargo ship off the coast of Florida. The U.S. military touts this experimental weapon, known as QUICKSINK, as a cost-effective solution for defeating surface vessels, providing American forces with expanded strike options in the maritime domain. The development of this weapon is part of a larger military-wide initiative to enhance anti-ship capabilities. Colonel Matthew Caspers, head of Air Force Research Laboratory, AFRL's Munitions Directorate at Eglin Air Force Base in Florida, said in a statement that the technology will ensure the U.S. can defend its interests, keep seas open, and seize the initiative over large maritime areas. He noted the significance of the demonstration. "The development of this technology helps deliver technological superiority to ensure the United States can defend our interests, maintain freedom of action, and seize the initiative over large maritime areas." In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how QUICKSINK could enhance the U.S. military's capacity to sink large enemy warships. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. This experimental weapon was first tested a few years ago, and most recently in a pair of tests in July, one during a series of live fire drills off the coast of Hawaii last month, and another in the Gulf of Mexico. In the Hawaii test, the missile fired from the B-2 bomber destroyed the defunct USS Tarawa amphibious assault ship, which measured 820 feet in length with a displacement of around 40,000 tons. In the Gulf of Mexico, Monarch Countess cargo ship was sunk. AFRL's Munitions Directorate continues to expand the QUICKSINK capability under the U.S. Air Force and Navy's broader maritime weapon program at Eglin Air Force Base, an initiative to amplify the military's anti-ship lethality using modern air-launched assets. In 2023, AFRL selected industry partner BAE Systems to develop an air-launched anti-ship munition seeker for the QUICKSINK effort. 1 year earlier, the agency tested a modified 2,000-pound or 907-kilogram guided bomb unit joint direct attack munition, or JDAM, from an F-15E Strike Eagle combat jet for the project. QUICKSINK pairs existing JDAM guidance kits with new seeker technology that allows the weapon to target stationary and moving targets, like ships, with precision. The JDAM is essentially a guidance kit that converts unguided bombs, or dumb bombs, into all-weather precision-guided munitions. The key components of the system consist of a tail section with aerodynamic control surfaces, a body strake kit, and a combined inertial guidance system and GPS guidance control unit. Once released from the aircraft, the JDAM autonomously navigates to the designated target coordinates. Target coordinates can be loaded into the aircraft before takeoff, manually altered by the aircrew before weapon release, or automatically entered through target designation with onboard aircraft sensors. So basically, the new seeker is the main difference here, as it can track a moving target. According to the Air Force Research Laboratory, the goal is to replicate the combat potential of a submarine with an aircraft that can cover a much larger area. QUICKSINK supports rapid attacks within budget and allows integration with current and future weapon systems for enhanced strikes against static and moving targets at sea. Additionally, it achieves a similar capacity to destroy vessels without giving off the user's location to adversaries compared to traditional ship-killing projectiles such as Mark 48 heavyweight torpedoes. The agency noted that the QUICKSINK weapon is not classified as a mine but is designed to have immediate effects on enemy platforms. JDAM uses 2,000-pound BLU-109 Mark 84, the 1,000-pound BLU-110 Mark 83, or the 500-pound BLU-111 Mark 82 warhead as the payload. For QUICKSINK, it should be the same. The only issue is that QUICKSINK is not a standoff weapon. JDAM has a published range of up to 28 kilometers or 17.5 miles, whereas for JDAM-ER it's around 75 kilometers or 46.5 miles. QUICKSINK is supposed to be the same. The limited range will require the launching aircraft to release it in close proximity to the target. In a conflict, QUICKSINK and the aircraft deploying it would face significant risks. For example, China's strong coastal air defense network, coupled with its modern destroyers and cruisers armed with advanced surface-to-air missile systems. So against near-peer rivals like China and Russia, QUICKSINK will most likely have to be deployed with caution and by stealthy aircraft. The U.S. Air Force has traditionally focused on land attack missions, resulting in limited anti-ship capabilities. However, the QUICKSINK program highlights the service's growing interest in sea denial operations. Recent tests demonstrate that the U.S. military could deploy one of its most survivable platforms, the B-2 Spirit stealth bomber, to sink a large surface ship using the low-cost guided bomb. Even though the QUICKSINK would not travel under the water and hit below the waterline, the Air Force hopes QUICKSINK would have a similar ship-killing effect as a traditional torpedo. The recent tests seem to prove that this notion is correct. Air Force officials say QUICKSINK would be cheaper and more flexible than heavyweight torpedoes and could be released from most of the service's combat aircraft. Interestingly, China, which is expanding its navy rapidly and inducting large surface combatants, was taking notes of the ship-sinking exercise even before the first July test was conducted. Global Times, which is essentially the mouthpiece of the Chinese Communist Party, stated, "The choice of the USS Tarawa as the sinking target reflects the concern of the US and its allies about the development and strength of China's maritime power, especially regarding the mainland's military deterrence on the Taiwan island. Such an outdated ship cannot be compared with modern military equipment." It's clear that with the QUICKSINK tests, the U.S. has delivered the right message to its rivals.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.